Hello, everyone. I'm Chen Jiexu from Intel, and another speaker is Yinan Chen. He is from Innsbruck. Today, I'm going to introduce a way to offload network policy to hardware. First of all, let's say what is network policy. Network policy is a concept in Kubernetes. If you are familiar with OpenStack, you can consider it as OpenStack security group. Network policy basically it will define which kind of traffic can go can be accepted or dropped. Let's say an example here. In this example, it contains almost everything about network policy you need to know. To define a network policy, there are four parts. First of all, you need to you need to have a pod selector. Pod selector will select the pod. Those pods is the pod the network policy should be applied. We can see here the pod selector will select the pod which have the label row DB, and then you need to have a policy type. There are two kinds of policy types, which is ingress and egress. It's the direction of the traffic. For ingress, it means the traffic going to the pod. For egress, it means the traffic going out the pod. And the third we can see ingress. Ingress means the pod means the traffic going to the pod. You can define IP block, namespace selector, and pod selector and pods. This will match the traffic. For example, if your traffic is a TCP traffic and the port is 6379, it will be accepted by this network policy. And the last is egress. Egress will specify which kind of traffic can go out the selected port. So. Usually, network policy is implemented by iptables, which means the traffic will go through the kernel space and it will consume some CPU resource. Today, I'm going to introduce a way just to offload network policy to the hardware, and then some traffic can be dropped in the hardware, which is NIC. Directly, and then CPU won't take part in, and we can save the CPU for our customers. Next, let's see our problem here. This problem is delivered with SR-IOV NIC plugin. For now, SR-IOV NIC plugin is supposed to use to be with Motus. Motus is can let port to have multiple interface. In this example, we have Calico as the default plugin, and the interface ETH0 is created by the Calico, and Night 1 is created by SR-IOV NIC plugin. Suppose we have a network policy which forbids port 1 to access port 2. Then you can't. Then the port 1 can't access port 2 through the ETH0, but you can still access. But the port 1 can still access the port 2 through the Night 1 because SR-IOV NIC plugin doesn't provide the support to. For network policy. This is the topology of the SR-IOV NIC. There is an internal switch in the NIC. SR-IOV provides one PF and multiple VFs. VF is provided to containers. Then containers or VM can use the VF to have the network. The traffic here, we can say VF1, the traffic between VF1 and VF2 is going like below. VF1, waypoint 1, and the internal switch, and waypoint 2, and VF2. So we can say if we offload the hardware, if we offload the network policy to the internal switch, then we can match the traffic and drop or accept the traffic. Then the traffic won't go through the kernel space. To offload the network policy to the hardware, we can use DPDK RTE flow library. this library can configure hardware to match specific ingress or egress traffic. The below flow command is from test PMD. Test PMD will finally call RTE flow library. In this command, we can see that there are ingress, egress, and transfer. The transfer is used for SR-IOV. For Python, we can match the specific traffic. And actions there, we can accept or drop the packet. There are a lot of in network policies. We need to use DPDK to implement the network policy. We need to figure out whether all the part of the network policy can be implemented by DPDK or not. So I compare them here. There are ingress and egress in network policy, and DPDK also have ingress and egress. For CIDR in network policy, we can use the last and mask to do the same thing like this example. And the except in the next network policy, we can also use to calculate which kind of IP block should be accepted or blocked. Then we can construct the flow command and offload the policy to the physical NIC. And for namespace selector and pod selectors, we just can use Kubernetes API. We can query the Kubernetes API and saying that we want to the pod which have the label like a row DB. And for pods DPDK has UDP, TCP, SCTP, and so on, which cover all of the network policies. So let's say my architecture. I got three components, which is network policy agent, SR-IOV CNI plugin, and DPDK agent. Network policy agent will watch the network policies and pod. If there is a new network policy created, then network policy will be notified, and then it will construct the flow command, finally, it will call DPDK agent through the socket, and DPDK agent can call the RTE flow library to set the network policy to the hardware finally. As always, CNI plugin also need to call DPDK agent to through the socket to configure the VF. Currently, I have posted this to the GitHub as an issue. We have several discussions over this, and hopefully I will continue to push this feature to SR-IOV CNI plugin. Finally, I'm going to deliver a demo. Here we can see this video. Okay. Okay. Here we say I have already. Here we can see a DPDK backend is already running. Next, I'm going to create the network policy agent. It is running in the Kubernetes node as a daemon site. Nextly, I'm going to create a network attachment, which is used by models to create multiple interface. And then I'm going to create two pods. This is pod one and pod two. These two pods both have two interfaces. ETH 0 is created by Calico, and night 1 is created by SR-IOV CNI plugin. We can see the IP. We can see the ETH 0 and night 1. We can see the IP assigned to those interfaces. We need to ping from port 2 to port 1 to verify that the traffic is the traffic can go through from port 2 to port 1. For now, network policy is not created. So we are in port 2 now. We are trying to ping the night 1 in port 1. So we can see the ping success. And then we will exit the port 2, and we will apply a network policy. This network policy will drop the traffic between port 1 and port 2. This network policy is offloaded to the hardware. That is the SR-IOV NIC. So we log in the port 2 again and trying to ping the IP in the port 1. So we can see the traffic is blocked. Okay, that's all. Thank you.